Voters in western Massachusetts and voters across the country take the typical Washington status quo and turn it on its head. It's going to be an upside down year. And there's a reason for why this is going to be one of those watershed moments in American politics. And the reason for that is that there's a lot of people in this country, and I actually meet them when I go throughout this congressional district, that are frustrated and angry and disappointed with what they see happening in Washington. This is our opportunity to go down and make a real difference in Washington in the way that people are interacting with their government. It's a brand new day. This district is now newly drawn. 86 cities and towns in western and central Massachusetts. I've been to every chicken dinner. I've been to every Rotary luncheon. John and I have been in the car. Others on this team, Shane, we've been in the car. We've moved around to a lot of different places. I want to tell you a story of just one young woman that I met a few months ago when we were in Holyoke. Here in Pittsfield, we have this thing called Third Thursday. In Holyoke, they have an annual event. It's similar. It's, you know, later in the year. It's just a one-time thing. It was an outdoor event. And when I was at that event in Holyoke, I had the pleasure of talking with a young woman named Michelle. She's in her 30s. Now, to call her a hardworking mom would be an understatement. In her 30s, two kids, 5 and 7, single, living in a rented apartment in Holyoke. She has a full-time job. She's a part-time student at the local community college. She's taking care of her elderly parents when she has the time. She's living in a rented apartment in Holyoke. And I talked with her about that. And she said to me, she said, "You're running for Congress?" I said, "Yeah, I am." She goes, "That sounds really tough." I said, "Well, you know, it is tough, but it's not nearly as tough as what you're doing. What's really tough for a lot of people in western Massachusetts and a lot of people across the country is getting the kids on the school bus and putting groceries on the table and making sure that you can take care of your elderly parents and get to work and do all the things you have to do in your household to keep things together. And I think that the task for people in Washington need to be thinking about the Michelles of the world and the Michelles of this country, making sure that those people are on their minds when they're making decisions down there."
Amen.
This is going to be a watershed moment in American politics because people in this country over the last several years have felt more and more detached from the people that are supposed to be representing them. That's what this election is going to be all about. Now, it means a lot of hard work from people like us. For us to really make this work, it means that we've all got to chip in. We've got to work together. This is a great opportunity for us. This district is brand new. It includes all of Berkshire County, and it takes us all the way through Westfield, Holyoke, East Hampton, Springfield, all the way to that southern tip of Worcester County. So we've got a lot of work ahead of us. Now, we've made good progress. Our fundraising has been very successful. Our organization is coming together very nicely. We've started to, we've got, what do we call them? Sleeper cells. We've got sleeper cells located throughout this district of people that have committed to us and they're going to work real hard. And that's everything from bumper stickers and lawn signs to the stuff that they're going to do online. But I need your help. We need your help. Connect us with your networks. Like us on Facebook. Tweet us, whatever that means. Go to our website. Sign up. Make sure that you're engaged with us online and that you connect us to your networks, because that's how this is going to happen. This ultimately is not going to be about politics. It might not even be about issues. It is going to be about people. So if you can help us with that, I'd appreciate it very, very much. That's all I ask. Thank you for being here. We will ask again. This is not the last time we're going to ask for something. But thank you very much for being here with us every step of the way. Thank you for being friends and family to me. We are going to do meet and greet events like this one. We did one in North Adams last night. We've got one here in Pittsfield today. We're going to do others in the future. And this is how we're going to win this thing, person by person. So thanks very much for being here. I appreciate all of you.